right, everybody, on to our fifth clutch group team attribute, and that is responsibility. And here's what I mean by that. That's a word that could mean a whole lot of things. And for us at the Clutch Group, here's what that means. You do what you say you're going to do, and you do what you know others expect you to do. So this is follow through. This is you. I'm not gonna let you down. It's gonna get done, and it's gonna get done on time. And if there's some crazy thing that's preventing that from happening, you're gonna find out about it. Like, we're gonna have a conversation. You're never gonna get let down because I didn't take responsibility for what was expected of me or for what I said I was going to do. This is an all-encompassing term for us that just means we're not gonna let each other down. And so this means if I have to, I'm gonna stay late tonight to make sure that that client gets taken care of, or those tasks that my teammate assigned to me are gonna get done. I'm gonna make sure that I follow through on all the little procedures and the way we do things, the mode of operation we have as a team. I'm gonna follow those because I know that if I don't, people are gonna get let down. They're gonna be confused. They're not gonna know what's happening. They're gonna be in the dark. And I don't want that to happen. So I'm gonna own and take responsibility for my own actions and make sure that I deliver at a high level and that I do exactly what everybody expects me to do. And it's also taking responsibility for your own actions. In other words, if something doesn't go well, if you commit to something and it doesn't happen the way it's supposed to happen, that's on you or that's on me. It's my responsibility. It's not someone else's fault. In fact, I say all the time with the team, when we're dealing with outside vendors, people who aren't on our team, you should expect that they're gonna fail. So if I say to Ashley, who works with me every day, and I say, hey, Ashley, I would like for you to make sure that the pool cleaner gets the pool cleaned by Friday on this listing we've got. She should be expecting and assuming in her head that it's not good enough to call on Monday and say, hey, pool cleaner, would you go by Friday and get the pool cleans? And he goes, yeah, great. That's not good enough. So here comes Friday and the pool cleaner forgot or he got busy and it doesn't get done. Ashley calls me and says, hey, yeah, sorry, it didn't get done. The pool cleaner screwed up. No, that's not taking responsibility for that task. That's blaming it on someone else, like the pool guy screwed up. In fact, she needs to assume that this guy's gonna fail. He's gonna screw up. Well, if you knew and felt like, hey, this guy's gonna screw this up, what would you do? You would go about this task in a different way. You'd make a follow-up call on Wednesday. Hey, you still good to go on Friday? You might set up a backup pool guy. Like, hey, listen, we got someone to do this job, but he's let me down in the past, or I my first time using him, and so I want you, can you be a backup just in case? We'll pay extra. And then Thursday she calls, okay. She sets it up with him to where on Friday he's gonna call back and say, I'm there at 10 a.m., I got it done. So that's taking responsibility. That's going, hey, one way or another, that pool is getting cleaned Friday, and I'm gonna own it, and if it doesn't happen, it's my fault. It's not the pool cleaner's fault, it's not the weather's fault, it's not traffic's fault, it is my fault. When you own things at that level, when you take that level of responsibility for things, it is incredible what you can accomplish at a team. Now, all of a sudden, all these vendors who could, you know, do things right or wrong or whatever, it's irrelevant. It's not the point. We as a team have done such a good job of preparing and executing and being responsible for what we're in charge of that things just go smoothly. And we're not putting out fires all the time and dealing with problems. And you start to only work with vendors who really do what they say they're gonna do. Like, you don't wanna babysit every single pool guy, right? So you find one who you can trust, who you can count on. And you, once he earns that trust, you are faithful to him and send him all the business. So everyone has some example of that in their job. And it's a matter of preparing ahead of time, of thinking ahead, of going, if I've gotta be at that lunch at noon, I'm not gonna leave at the last minute. I'm gonna leave with plenty of margin so that if the traffic is bad, things go sideways on me, I can still get there no problem. I'm gonna have a backup plan and then a backup to the backup plan. I'm gonna own this. This thing's gonna get done. Again, back to what I said in a previous attribute, this is 80-20 as well, right? There are some things that are worth major time and some things that are worth minor time. So some appointments, you better freaking be sure you get there. And some, there's a little bit more margin for error. But at the end of the day, it's important that we are responsible for our commitments and for what is expected of us. If one of the team members asks you to do something by a certain time in a certain way, then it better get done that way. That's so critical around here because it allows us to execute and trust each other. And when we can trust each other, we can operate so much more quickly and efficiently. So it's a wonderful attribute. It's one of the things that makes us who we are, and it will help you grow as a person into someone who really means what they say when they commit to something. So our latest attribute, responsibility. I encourage you to dig in and think about how you can be more responsible for your own commitments and actions here at the Clutch Group.